I'd
say this is probably the second most asked about piece. It's not that it has the date in there, it's just what has a serial number. I want to say lack. Oh, it is reduced density. The reduced density makes it look more natural. Hey everybody, I just got a wig dropped off to me that Sophie had reconditioned, literally like conditioned and then recolored. And so I haven't actually put it on. I literally just actually pulled it out of the bag and I'm like, I'll make a video for anybody that wants to see about reconditioning their pieces and what that kind of looks like, because I have probably many pictures of this wig that I can fish out and put like along here somewhere, I think, or over here or somewhere around here, to show you guys that a wig can have many lives. So when you move on to get a new piece, if you do that, you can definitely still be using that one and it could just be a nice addition in a different style to what you are maybe traditionally used to. So like I don't really wear permed hair. This is a permed wig, but it's like a nice thing to have in my wig wearing rotation. And people seem to love the perm, actually, by the way. This particular piece is, I think it's from, if I can figure it out by looking at this. Yeah, it's from 2015. So it's not that it has the date in there, it's just what has a serial number. It's from 2015. And so this started off not with the beachy wave perm that was done in 2017, and started out with an ashy brown. So I definitely know I have those photos that I can show you guys. And so you can see how like a wig can just change. And this, by the way, this wig has like dramatically less hair than when it started and than most of my wigs, because it's been used so much. It's been colored several times over, it's been permed, it's had a very like long life, wig wearing time with me. I've worn this piece a lot. People love this wig. The one that I feel like has the least amount of hair possible and is old, but it is kept very well by Sophie taking care of it for me. So you definitely would do well having a person that you entrust with your wigs to condition them and color them. And maybe if you want to change the style, you can do that. It's definitely really helpful. So because of that, my most popular piece, or I would say this is probably the second most asked about piece I've had over the duration of time, I would say, that I've worn hair. It's this one and another one, actually. They all look good, but people tend to gravitate to those particular ones. And the reason why I think that they do is because they look so natural. They've been so colored. They are not exactly perfect. That because of those factors that occurred, like I didn't just go and like, you know, destroy the wig or something like that. It's like happened with age, but because they look so natural, I think that's why people are drawn to them. You know, when we look for hair, we're always looking, we think we're looking for like, oh, you need that perfect, or you want that perfect piece. Well, we do, of course, you know, you're investing in this, you want to get the best hair possible, but you'll also find that you want the most natural hair, by the way, is going to be the one that, believe it or not, like the one that looks like the least attractive on my mannequin head, the ones that look the least attractive on my mannequin head actually are the ones that look the best on me, which is crazy, right? But the ones that like look the best on her, it's not that they don't look good on me, it's just that like they don't, it's like the head doesn't do it justice. It comes to life on a human, if that makes sense. It basically goes or can oxidize a lot over time, and it can go like brassy or orange. And so on a lot of my pieces, I need to have that part kept up with. And also I have the front pieces lightened because my hair is super, super gray now. It used to be blonde gray. It's just basically gray. So by having the front pieces lightened like this, like, I don't know if you can see that, like they're different. It will really help to blend whatever few hairs I'm pulling out and make it look more natural. So I really am digging the color. I haven't even put this on my head, but it's very soft. So the conditioning treatment really worked. It's really dry. It was really, really, really dry. It was really, really like orangey blonde. It was basically, I was actually convinced that the life of, that it had reached its lifespan, which would have been fine. But so what I'll do is I will pop this on and see what she looks like and share that with you guys. Okay, I'll be right back. Okay, so we have gone from this ensemble to this ensemble. I love the coloring and I love how soft it is. So this was just conditioned and it was recolored. It's from 2015 and it was permed in 2017, which I know I have a photo of that one, of the day I picked it up. And then I also mentioned it again on a video from 2018 where I said I was using this particular piece for my re-entry into daytime wig wearing because I had taken a break from it. And if you take a break for a while from wearing wigs, you can find that you feel them initially, but in time you get used to it. It's like anything else. I've always said, you know, yes, there's awareness, but there's awareness almost in the regard that I put like equivalent to like, I'm aware I'm wearing shoes. I'm aware I have a shirt on. You know, if I left my body out with those without those items for some time, when I put the shoes back on and I put the shirt back on, if I wasn't doing it every day, I would probably feel them initially. It's kind of the same thing for me with wigs. It is the same thing. So if I'm doing it every single day, you're just used to it. It's just part of it. Boom, hair on, you're aware it's there, but it's like whatever. If you take massive amounts of time off when you first put the hair back on, you may find that you're like, oh, I'm feeling the wig right now. And just like in a couple days or a day, it's not a big deal. But I had taken a break for a short time in 2018 from wearing wigs. And then when I went back to wanting to wear them full time, I decided to use this piece to kind of start back in because of the age and stuff like that, it has less hair. Because of the perm, it stays out of my face. Wigs tend to want to go forward. So it has a lot of pluses going for it, and it just looks really nice. It looks very natural. The lack, I don't want to say lack, oh, it is reduced density. The reduced density makes it look more natural. The perm makes it look more natural. The coloring makes it look more natural. The perm helps it stay out of the face. It's lightweight. It's just a very easy wear. So love this wig. Everybody loves this wig. People online love this wig. They always ask me about it. And my family loves this wig. This is the one that I feel like I've gotten more wig compliments in the totality of all my wigs for the last 8 years, probably on this piece, which surprises me actually, because yeah, I would think it would be a couple of other pieces, but as a whole, people really love this wig, and with good reason too. It looks great. So if you did a fantastic job giving this wig another life, and so I'm super appreciative of that, because I actually thought this one was a goner, to be honest with you. I was like, well, it had a good run, you know. So that would be about all I have for you guys today. If you haven't already, please hit the subscribe button below to get more videos like this. And if you found this video useful in any way, shape, or form, definitely give it a like. I would appreciate it greatly. And I will talk to you guys soon. Bye.